Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. I'm so excited to be here today because it's another day of our heavenly encounters. An opportunity to fellowship with the Holy Spirit. An opportunity to bless Jesus Christ. An opportunity to exalt the name of God Almighty. To share visions with you. To share encounters. To share revelations that will transform your life. You are blessed. If you have not met me, my name is Apostle Marvin Omede. I'm sent by God to teach power, to hear from God, and to make the ministry of the Holy Spirit popular. You are blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you still desiring to meet Jesus? Are you still desiring to have an heavenly encounter? Are you still desiring to visit the throne room? It's your season to have fellowship one-on-one with the Holy Spirit, to hold Him, to hug Him, to embrace Him, to sit on the lap of Jesus Christ. This shall be your testimony in the name. Please, if you have not subscribed, subscribe, because more are coming. This is just the beginning. This episode 22, more are coming. Hallelujah. What eyes have not seen and what ears have not heard shall be the order of your testimony in this season. In the name of Jesus, you are blessed. It is well with you. Congratulations. In Jesus' wonderful name, amen. Hallelujah. Today we are going to do something. We are going to pray a very short prayer. A prayer that I always want to pray when I'm alone. That the Lord should order your step. May 28, 2020, I was seated on my own when God ordered my step. To have an encounter with my mentor today. That was the first day I saw the image of Jesus Christ. My eyes was opened. Today your eyes shall be opened in the name of Jesus Christ. Before we pray, let me share a scripture with you. I'm in a prayer group here in America. And yesterday, one of the leaders, 2 days ago, was leading the prayer meeting. And he mentioned the scripture, Psalms 91. Hallelujah. Psalms 91 verse 4. Let me read it and I'll tell you what happened. That's why I want your ears to be open and your eyes also will be open. Psalm 91 verse 4. It says, "It shall cover thee with his feathers," right? "It shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust." As I heard, I know what the Holy Spirit said. Holy Spirit said, they are talking about me. Hallelujah. If you have your Bible, go and read it. Psalm 91 verse 4. He said, "It shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler." As he said, "shall cover thee with his feathers," right? "Under his wings shall thou trust." When he mentioned feathers, I saw it. When he mentioned wings, I saw it. Because I have met with the Holy Spirit. I have seen the Holy Spirit as a big eagle. He do come and fellowship with me. So, Holy Spirit told me, say, it's me that they are talking about. So, if you have your Bible and you don't know, you think that thing was just literary. No. It's only just a word. It wasn't just written because they want to write it. Holy Spirit said, that's me the scripture was talking about. The secret I'm talking about. More is to come. It's your season of ritual. It's your season of encounter. So let us pray that prayer. Say, Lord, order my step in your word. Lord, order my step according to your word. You want to pray that prayer. Lord, order my step. Because that's one part of my greatest prayer points, which is, Lord, help me to align in your perfect will. That's what you are telling God. God's perfect will for you is the best for you. Not his permissive will. No, not the one you want. His perfect will. Hallelujah. Lord, order my step according to your word. In the name of Jesus. Are you a pastor here? Say, Lord, order my step according to your word in my ministry. Do you desire a peaceful marriage? Lord, order my step. Do you desire financial blessings? Lord, order my step. To that breakthrough, enough of hardship. Lord, order my step. Do you desire a relationship? Relationship that are based on the word of God, that brings joy and happiness whenever people see you or whenever you meet with people. They want to have fellowship with you because of the grace of God upon your life. Nehemiah said, when I went to meet with the king, everything I inquired, desired of the king gave them to me because of the gracious hand of God that was upon my life. Today that hand shall rest upon you in the name of Jesus. So let us pray. Father, order the step of everyone watching me in this hour. Order them to their own season of encounters. Order them to their own season of breakthroughs. Order them to their own season of testimonies. Order their step, O Lord. As they go out, order their step. As they come in, order their step. In the name of Jesus, let your angels go before them and protect their going out, breaking down every barrier, making them every crooked way straight. In the name of Jesus, Jesus, all that is step of your children, all that your step, no one will live your perfect way, no one will live your perfect way. It is written, he said, there should bring wisdom, there should bring wisdom. You shouldn't count this, there should have value to you, there should have value to you, there should bring wisdom to you. In the name of Jesus, Abba escort a letter shuttle. In Jesus' wonderful bread, amen. It is well with you. You shall be increased in wisdom. God will order your step and align you with his perfect way, where everything is peace. He said, when they have decided and agreed to serve God, in 2 Chronicles, he said, Lord, give them peace round about peace. You are sleeping, you are going in peace. You are waking up, in peace. That shall be your testimony. In Jesus' name, you are blessed. Amen.
Hallelujah. We welcome you once more to another day of broadcast in the name of Jesus Christ. This is Heavenly Encounters with Apostle Marvin Omede, where we share heavenly testimonies, where we share heavenly visitations, where we share visions and revelations in line with the seer's anointings. In this ministry, your eyes shall be opened in the name of Jesus Christ. Remember, we have a sister segment of this broadcast where we call, How Do I Begin to See? How Do I Begin to See? Follow us on that platform and shall be blessed in Jesus' name. We have tips and ideas simplified are shared for your benefit, to encourage you and to mentor you to see easily and hear easily in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. We bless God. First of all, I want to start with you believing as you are listening to this testimony. Believe them from the depth of your heart. If you have any iota of doubt, you will not gain the blessings that are attached to it. I'm the type of very young prophet that is not excited to come and tell you anything. No, if God has not told me. I was not sent to prophesy. I was sent to teach. Maybe that's the reason, the privilege that I have to see more than I desire. And I'm still hungry. I'm still hungry for more. So believe what you see. What I share with you is what I've seen, what my hands have handled of the word of life to his glory. Not because I desire it or I qualify for it. It was a privilege God brought upon me because of my hunger and taste for righteousness. God will bring that same grace upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. Surely for those of you that are God's children, when I mean God's children, serving God from the depth of your heart, giving up everything in sacrifice to God, and ministers of God that labor in word and doctrine, sincerely, that God will increase your anointing under this platform. Receive that grace in the name of Jesus Christ. God will meet you at the point of your need and will increase your anointing, and you shall be satisfied in him. In Jesus' name, amen. What I'm talking about is related to today's testimony. It happened October 17, 2020. That's when I had this encounter. And it's titled, "He said, I needed to train you alone. I needed to train you alone." Let me give you a background, because whenever Holy Spirit gives you an encounter, he explains it to you. He gives you the meaning behind what he's showing you. That's why our God is so awesome. He's the greatest teacher. Says the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profit nothing. The words I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. The Holy Spirit, he teaches you, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. Hallelujah. That's why you have to be in the spirit when you listen to these encounters, for you to understand the revelations behind them. I'm not telling stories. Whatever I've seen, that's what I've told you. See the date, October 17, 2020. So I'm not rushing to come and share it. It's just there. I go through them. I just enjoy them. And the Holy Spirit guides me to know what to teach part time to his glory. It's your season of breakthrough.
You too will soon start sharing your testimonies in the name of Jesus Christ, all to his glory. He said, I needed to train you alone. Have you been in a situation sometimes you continue to pray because you desire a particular thing? You are ready for it. You want God to do this testimony, to promote your life, to take you to a next level. But as you pray, you continue in fellowship, nothing is happening. Nothing is happening. As if God is not hearing you. I was in this situation. Hallelujah. He said, I needed to train you alone. Look at the testimony. Look at the encounter.
In October 17, 2020, I was in this vision and I saw a very big building. And first of all, a lady came out of the building, well dressed, right? Corporate dressing. Then a guy came out too. And then I knew that there were more people in that building. I see they were dressed for an interview, right? To get a job or something like that. So people began to come out of the building. Then later they stay in a queue, in a line. They were, you know, they filed out in a line, maybe waiting to be called in again. Then I saw from a distance, birds were coming, a big bird. And whenever I see a big bird like that in a vision, that's the Holy Spirit. As the bird came close to this people on queue, the bird went close towards a lady. As he got to the lady, picked up a child from the hand of the lady, and the bird flew up. The Holy Spirit flew up with this child. I was looking at the Holy Spirit. Then it began to fly. We flew very high in the sky and left the child. Hallelujah. As he left the child, I was saying, what's going on here? The child was coming out. Before the child could drop to the ground, the bird flew back and picked the child up and took the child back up to the sky. I was watching. After a while, leaves the child again. Child coming down with speed to drop to the earth. No, the Holy Spirit will pick up the child again. If you are, as you are listening, if you have heard the story of the ego, you know the Holy Spirit is the biggest ego, is the greatest ego. That's how egos train their children. Is anybody connecting? You shall be trained in the name of Jesus Christ. When God trains you, He leaves you hot. He says it makes His angel spirit, it means a flame of fire. A bullet does. A push, it leaves you hot. You are not confused. You are not frustrated. You are not thinking, what should I do next? It will show you before you get there to His glory. And I began to look, thinking the child will drop down. It will pick up the child again. That's specifically how egos train their children. And I began to ask, Holy Spirit, what is going on? He said, you are being trained. He said, let me read from this part. You grab what I'm saying. I said the child before, the sweet Holy Spirit will pick up the child again. Then I began to receive interpretation for this encounter. The Lord said, I am the little baby. Because you that is in the vision, whatever you see the Holy Spirit hold, or Jesus holding a baby, or maybe sometimes you will be 7 years old, 3 years old, 2 years old, depends on how the heavenly host wants you to appear. He said, you are the little baby that they are training up. He said, you are the little baby and concerned. You know, he said, it wasn't, and then he said, for the prayer that you have been praying for that have not been answered, he said, it wasn't anyone's fault. It is because you are being trained. I need there to train you alone. Some of you that knows me very well, you understand what I'm talking about. I need there to train you alone. Not that I didn't want to answer your prayer. I needed you alone so that I can release things into your life. If by your sakoto, let me pray for somebody. Anything that wants to distract you from not getting the best of God in this season, may God separate you from them. In Proverbs 18 verse 1, he says, a man having separated himself, intermediate with all wisdom. There are certain wisdom that will never come upon you when you go in crowd. When you go in the company of people that may not be aligning with the will of God for your life. That is why every time, stay more alone. Say, Lord, do I go this way? Lord, do I go this way? That's why we started with, Lord, order my step in your word. You are not wanted everywhere. You are not needed everywhere. Stay where God wants you to be. You see, that's why I want us to grow in wisdom. If this is where most people miss, actually ministers of God sometimes, with all humility. We are places you shouldn't be. You see, I would have answered your prayer then, but don't worry, I needed you alone. I needed to train you alone. I love that part. Say, it wasn't anybody's fault. Don't blame what the excuses were. No. I heard your prayers, but I needed to train you alone. So I have to separate you to myself. Is somebody being separated in this season and you are not understanding it? You think God has forsaken you? You think God has abandoned you? No. He said, I heard your prayer. What he says to one, he says to all. I heard what you were praying about. It wasn't anybody's fault. Not that your prayer was not strong enough. Not that you were not doing the right thing. Not that you were not paying your tithe or going to church or reading your Bible. No, it's beyond that. I just wanted you to myself.
So that when you are not donned, when you are not cooled, when you are not prepared, when you are not sanctified, no weapon fashioned against you will prosper. When you open your mouth and speak, there will be fire. People will hear what eyes have not seen, what ears have not, what has not entered into the hearts of men. Let him train you. Let him train you. When I got this, I said, okay, now I know. Not that something was wrong. May God grant us understanding. People are receiving peace in their hearts as they are listening to this. So really, it wasn't my fault. No, it wasn't my prayer life. No, it wasn't my this. It was just that God needed me alone for his season. And hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Some of you are going through that season now. Some of you are going through it now. Say, so really? Is it because he wanted me alone that I've not received this? That I've not gotten this promotion? That I've not moved to this place? He wanted you alone. I needed to train you alone. It is well with you. It is well with you. It is well with you. May God visit you by himself in this season. May God transform your life. May these encounters open your eyes in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me round off with this. My name is Apostle Marvin, a man sent by God to teach people how to hear from God and to make the ministry of this people popular. With all humility, I started learning how to hear from God 2014 after he called me officially. And since then, I've been learning how to hear from God. Then I began to teach it. After teaching how to hear from God for a while, the Lord opened my eyes. The Lord called the seers and anointing. And I began to see through visions and revelation. And give me details of what I see. That's how clear it was. With utmost clarity. In fact, I asked for more. I said, Lord, won't you take me to open heaven? Open my eyes like broad daylight. And he did it. Since then, I see very clearly. That's why I describe what I see. May God open your eyes in the name of Jesus Christ. May God open your eyes in the name of Jesus Christ. And may it visit you afresh. May be able to describe as I describe my encounters in Jesus' name. It is well with you. Don't hold yourself back from anything you needed to know. Or you need to know that will transform your spiritual life. Continue in grace. In the grace of God is with you in Jesus' name. You are blessed. Please don't forget to subscribe and share this broadcast so other people can be blessed. Let people be aware. Yes, thank you, Jesus. I want to specially thank a lot of you that have subscribed. When we started earlier this year, it was just 4 subscribers. Today we are 36 subscribers. I don't know where they came from, but God knows your name. You are blessed. You are blessed. May the grace of God rest with you. Thank you for subscribing to this channel. Then secondly, those that watches the broadcast, the viewers have increased. I saw 81 views. I say, what? Really? So people are grasping it. They are getting the revelation. You are blessed. In the name of Jesus Christ, let them go through you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You just reminded me what I wanted to say. This is just the beginning. Don't miss out. This episode 22. There is more to come. This is just the beginning. This is just the beginning. So that we won't get God. God always starts his thing at the lowest level where we can understand. More encounters are to come. That when you hear them say, really? I thought I've heard. No, you have not heard. This is just the beginning. More are coming. More. I'm still praying for more of power and grace. So please connect to this level and enjoy them so you can grow with us. It is well with you in Jesus' name. Amen. Congratulations. See you in our next broadcast. I'm so excited. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You say, I needed to train you alone. Stay with him. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.